Focus stacking is a photography technique used in landscape and macro photography to keep everything in focus. Today I'll talk about focus stacking for landscape photography, why you need to know about it, how to photograph for this technique, how to edit the photos, and also a few dirty little secrets and tips. Because of physics and the way the lens are built, every combination of focal length, aperture, focus point distance, and the size of the sensor will result in a different depth of field. As a rule of thumb, the smaller the aperture, this means the higher the F number, like F8, F11, or F16, and the further the focus distance point, the bigger the depth of field. There are situations when you want everything in focus, and you also want to photograph with wide-angle lens. Using these lenses usually means getting really low and creating a really dynamic photo, but this means you'll also have a lot of elements really close to you and your lens. Sometimes the elements are that close that even closing the aperture at f16 will not keep everything in focus. It's also useful to know the hyperfocal distance, because this will tell you that for a certain focal length and a certain aperture, you need to focus at a minimum certain distance in order to have a depth of field starting at a value and ending to infinity. The closer the aperture, the smaller the hyperfocal distance, and the depth of field starts closer to you, and thus it's bigger. For example, a 17mm focal length on a full frame body and the aperture of f11 has the hyperfocal distance of 1.12 meters, thus creating a depth of field starting at 0.5 meters and ending to infinity. But what about the elements that are closer than 0.5 meters to you? There are some cases that just can't be solved like this. The objects and elements of the photo are so close to you that you need to do something else in order to have a photo that has all the elements in photos. And now enters this technique, focus stacking. Focus stacking refers to a technique where you take multiple photos focusing at different distances from you. The result is 2, 3, or 5 photos, depending on how many you need, that when combined will result in one perfect photo that will have all the elements in sharp. In order to achieve this result, you first need the tripod and the trigger, because it's very important to have the camera in the exact same place every photo. Then you need to keep your settings on full manual, because you don't want to change settings between photos. Third, you need to pay attention to light, because you don't want that to change either. Fourth, analyze if focus stacking is doable for your situation. For example, if you have flowers very close to you in the foreground that are blown away by the wind, you'll have a really difficult time combining these photos in Photoshop, simply because the flowers will look different in every photo. After you establish your composition, start focusing on the closest element to you. If the first element is really, really close to you, you'll need to do 5 photos. Usually focus really close to you, then 1/3 of the image, and then in the background. But if you have elements that are really, really close to you, just to be sure that you get everything in focus, do the first 3 photos by focusing really close to you, then the 4th photo focus at 1/3 of the image, and then the 5th photo in the background. Now that you have the 3 or 5 photos, you'll need to move to Photoshop. A small tip is to have a personal sign that tells you the following photos are for focus stacking. For example, before every focus stacking series of photos, I photograph my hand and the same at the end. This way I know that all the photos between these 2 signals need to be combined. Otherwise, you'll forget about it, especially if you photograph the same composition over and over again on a longer period of time. Now let's open Photoshop. First, you need to open all the photos. The easiest way to open all the photos into one document is to go File, Script, and Load Files into Stack. This will open all the photos as layers in a single document. I'll open the photos using Lightroom. So for that, I will Ctrl-click to select all the photos, right-click, edit in, and open as layers in Photoshop. Then you select all the layers, click on the first layer, then Shift-click on the last one, and you have all them selected. Then go to Edit, Auto Blend Layers, click on Stack Images, and also check the 2 boxes below, and you just hit OK. Now you wait for a second and let Photoshop to do its magic, and then you get a new layer that has all the images combined into one, and you have everything in focus. Thanks for watching. You can support me by buying one of my editing classes, link in the description below, and until next time, keep on photographing. It's the only way you can get better. Bye bye.